So very good afternoon to all. My colleague Dr. Natasha gave a very wonderful talk on how we are in the era of using smart lubricants. But we are not always sure that when to use it and how to use it. So I'm just going to give a small insight on a kit which we are developing and which will be soon into your practice because the chip is in my hand and how we can customize the treatment for each patient. So let me start with this very interesting case of a 26-year-old female patient, high myopia, normal pre-op topography, normal indices, everything within normal limits. She wanted to undergo refractive surgery, so we went ahead and did the same for her. We did a smile surgery for her, but however, to our surprise, she came back to us after 3 years and she had developed ectasia in both the eyes. At this point of time, we were really wondering that how did she develop ectasia? Everything preoperatively was within normal limits. Even we do biomechanics for all our patients and that was also within normal limits. So what was going wrong? Interestingly, we had strode a lenticule for her when she was undergoing a smile surgery. So after 3 years when she developed ectasia, we could retrieve her lenticule and do some molecular analysis on the same to see how it looks. So if you see here, these are all the normal pre-op topographies, but if you see this images, the extracellular matrix images, this is how your corneal stroma looks. The white bands which you see are the collagen fibrils and the colorful structure which you see inside it is the LOX enzyme, which LOX enzyme is nothing but a cross-linking enzyme and it keeps the collagen fibrils in place and tightly bounded to each other. Interestingly, what we found was that for this patient who developed ectasia, the LOX enzyme, which tightly bonds the collagen together, was low to begin with preoperatively itself. It was lower before the surgery, and that led to lowering of the collagen weak fibers and led to collagen weakening, which might have led to ectasia. So this case is the first in its kind, a novel find that LOX and collagen A levels can lead to ectasia. And this was recently published in JRS, where it suggested that reduced pre-existing LOX and collagen levels may predispose healthy eyes to refractive surgery. And if preoperative molecular testing may reveal ectasia susceptibility in absence of tomographic or biomechanical risk factors, it would be great. So if we can identify this molecular risk factors preoperatively, then we could probably save this kind of hazards. So we wanted to do further some analysis and we wanted to find out whether we are right in our concept or not. So what we did was all the patients undergoing smile surgery with different topographies, different pachymetry index, different patterns, we collected the lenticule and we did analyze them for the same molecular testing we did for the smile patient. We did a quantitative polymerase chain reaction. And interestingly, what we found was that the topographies and the LOX and the collagen levels did not match. Patients with probably lower pachymetry or borderline topography had higher levels of LOX, which you can see here in the bars. I'm sorry, my pointer is not working. And the patient which developed ectasia with a completely and absolutely normal topography preoperatively had low levels of LOX, suggesting that these are different screening factors. Topography and molecular factors can aid as a different screening tool in future. So what is LOX? As I explained earlier, this is the same slide. It just in the corneal stroma, it binds the corneal collagen fibrils together. Also, our group has previously published that in keratoconus patients, if the LOX levels are higher in the cornea, the outcomes of cross-linking were much better than the patients who had lower levels of LOX, suggesting that it has also got a role in cross-linking. So what did proof of concept showed that low levels of LOX, decreased collagen can lead to ectasia. But this is a very elaborate procedure. How can we bring it to our clinic in a very simplified tool? And how can we convert this science part of it into our clinics? So we are currently working on this point of care diagnostic kit. This is our dream project, where what we are doing actually is different antigens of like inflammatory factors, ECM remodelers like LOX and collagens, they are injected in this rabbit. And from this rabbit, the antibodies are produced. Once we have these biomarker-specific antibodies for each of the factors, this antibody-specific specific antibodies are actually injected in this chip. This is the chip in my hand, how it looks. And you can put different antibodies in this chip-like structure. And this will go directly into the small purple object which you see here. It will be nothing like, but it will be like a glucometer kit. How you can measure your blood sugar levels in your clinics or your home, it will be similarly like that. It will be such a small subject. And you can actually preoperatively measure these levels, like inflammatory markers for your dry eye or your refractive surgery, the LOX levels, the collagen levels, and you can actually screen these patients, treat them if needed preoperatively, and then take up the patient for surgery. We are looking right now at tears, but in future the aqueous and the vitreous samples can also be analyzed with this kit for different markers. Then this is the kit. We know that probably there is inflammation present or the LOX levels are low, but can we formulate any topical novel therapy to modulate these factors? Lot of groups are currently working on this factor, enhancing LOX. Also, if you reduce the inflammation with cyclosporine or trehalose drops, it can help in a better healing. But our group is currently working on two strongest immunomodulators present in the body, which is the vitamin D and the curcumin, which is a medical-based curcumin drop. And we are trying to find a role of the same in as a LOX enhancer. What we did was we have taken human corneal epithelial cell lines and we have induced hyperosmotic stress and created inflammation for the same. What happens is when we create inflammation or induce inflammation, the LOX levels reduce, but at the same time when they were treated with different concentrations or combinations of medical based curcumin and vitamin D, if you can see here, these are the plus and the minus signs, and if you can see the red band of 6, 7 and 8, the LOX levels increase and the inflammation reduces, suggesting that both vitamin D and curcumin have a potential role in enhancing LOX. So if I come back to the kit, where we are right now, we are right now in the phase of testing the sensitivity and the specificity of the kit, which will be soon commercially available, and it will be like a lab in your own clinic. And with this kit, and we can measure the inflammatory markers, low LOX levels, we can treat them with LOX in, enhancers or reduce the inflammation in dry eye, and we can have a better prediction for our surgery, and we can stay safe for the same for both us and for the patients in future. Thank you.